What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. Let us pray. O Lord, the gracious Heavenly Father, we come before you here today. O Lord, bless each and every one of us who have been seated here with good wisdom and knowledge, O Father. And as we rebuke all kind of evil spirits that's working among us, we rebuke them in your mighty name. Help us, O Lord, to come before you with grateful hearts. O Lord, bless each and every one of us, O Lord, so that we may not go astray, but rather remain in your promises. We submit the rest of the time into your mighty hands. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us sing song number 153, Heaven Came Down. Song number 155, Kartar Nallavar Thudiyungal. From the Bible for the responsive reading is taken from Psalms 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs.
Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture.
Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name.
Let's read the last verse together. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues to all generations. Amen. Let us turn our pages to the Apostles' Creed and let us read it together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell the third day and rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We have not a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sinning. Let us examine ourselves and say the confession prayer. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred astray from the ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and the desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone the things you ought to have done, and we have done the things you ought not to have done. And there is no health in us, but thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Miserable offenders, spare thou them. O God, confess their faults, restore thou them that are patient. According to the promise declared unto making in Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may have to live a godly, righteous, and sober life. To the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Let us say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them those trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let's pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, thank you for being with us throughout this time, O Lord. Continue to be with us, O Lord, and let your wisdom and knowledge be with us, O Father. Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us sing song number 154. Because he lives.
God sent his Son, they called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all doubt is gone. Because I know and say, he holds the future. Still, the common show runs.
Let us sing song number 156, Unnathathin Aaviye.
Unnathathin Aaviye, Unnan Bhaktar Vinathi, Utra Vendum Indra Naadiye. Ulagamengum Saatchi Naangale. Unnathathin Aaviye, Unnan Bhaktar Vinathi, Utra Vendum Indra
From the Bible for the first Bible reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verses 12 to 18. I, the teacher, was king over Israel in Jerusalem. I devoted myself to study and to explore by wisdom all that is done under heaven. What a heavy burden God has laid on man. I have seen all the things that are done under the sun. All of them are meaningless, a chasing wind after the wind. What is twisted cannot be straightened. What is lacking cannot be counted. I thought to myself, look, I have grown and increased in wisdom more than anyone who has ruled over Jerusalem before me. I have experienced much of wisdom and knowledge. Then I applied myself to the understanding of wisdom and also of madness and folly. But I learned that this too is a chasing after the wind. For with much wisdom comes much sorrow. And more knowledge, the more grief. Amen. I'd like to call Reverend Elizabeth for the second Bible reading.
The chosen part from the Holy Bible for the second Bible reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke chapter 14, verses 25 to 35. Large crowds were traveling with Jesus, and turning to them, he said, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate his father and mother, his wife and children, his brothers and sisters, yes, even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. And anyone who does not carry his cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. Suppose one of you wants to build a tower. Will he not first sit down and estimate the cost to see if he has enough money to complete it? For if he lays the foundation and is not able to finish it, everyone who sees it will ridicule him, saying, 'This fellow began to build and was not able to finish.' Or suppose a king is about to go to war against another king. Will he not first sit down and consider whether he is able with 10,000 men to oppose the one coming against him with 20,000? If he is not able, he will send a delegation while the other is still a long way off and will ask for terms of peace. In the same way, any of you who does not give up everything, he cannot be my disciple. Salt is good, but if it loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is fit neither for the soil nor for the manure pile. It is thrown out. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. Amen.
Let us sing song number 152, Nandriyal Thuthipaadu.
Nandriyal Thuthipaadu, Nam Yesuvai Namale Endru Paadu. Nandriyal Thuthipaadu, Nam Yesuvai Namale Endru Paadu. Vallavan, Nallavan, Podumanavan, Vaarthaiyum Nallavan. Vallavan, Nallavan, Podumanavan, Vaarthaiyum Nallavan. Nandriyal Thuthipaadu, Nam Yesuvai Namale Endru Paadu.
Nam Yesuvai Namale Endru Paadu.
Let us sing song number 174, Ummodi Irupathu Thaan. Thank you. For today's short meditation, let us turn our pages to Psalms 139, verses 1 to 6. O Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in behind and before. You have laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Here in these six verses, we see that how David is portraying God, that he knows everything. Throughout this chapter, we see in the first six verses, we see basically the psalmist is trying to tell us God knows everything and we should not fool with him. There are some personal pronouns in these six verses where we understand that God knows us personally. In a huge crowd, if we are to recognize few of the faces that we know, there will be very few. Like in a huge crowd, if there are two people that we know, to recognize them, it takes us some time. You see, that's our human knowledge. That's our human perceive. Sometimes we take time to recognize people. Sometimes it happens to me also, even when I see some of them who I know, it takes quite a long time to recognize who they are after seeing years back. Here we see God is not unable to recognize, but he recognizes us personally and he knows everything. In our course of life, when we feel like nobody cares for us or nobody knows us or even nobody understands us, here in these verses we see how psalmist is encouraging and telling that God knows everything and he understands us. Even before we say, we see God knows what we are going to say. And intimately, it is God who knows us the very best, even more than what we know about ourselves. He knows our words. And in verse 4 we see, before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. Even before we think to say a word, God knows what we are going to say. So he is so much powerful that he knows us personally, internally, and intimately. We see how God knows everything about us. But what about us? Well, how do we know God? We may not know about him everything. But today I would like to encourage that we should not be disappointed that we don't know about ourselves, or nobody recognizes us, or nobody is willing to know us, or nobody is understanding us. In these times, we need to remember that what the psalmist says, nobody might not understand us, but who understands us? Our God the Father who understands us. In this chapter, we see the psalmist further goes to saying, he's behind me, he's before me, he's laid his hand upon me, and he is sovereign. So we can't fool around God, telling that why he persecutes us, why he doesn't know us, or why nobody understands us. Understand that he is the most sovereign God that we can rely on. So let us be careful in everything that we do. And what should be our response? Basically, our response should be like the psalmist saying, praise the Lord. We should be more glad that God the Father knows us so deeply and intimately and understands us personally. This should lead us to take away all our fear. We should not be afraid of any situations, and it should give us more confidence. If we are afraid and if we are confident, then we doubt God's presence, then we doubt God's intimacy with us. Even though we are not intimate with God, we see how God intimately knows us. And for that, we should be more thankful and grateful. And overall, I'd like to encourage today that we need to have this confidence that no matter
who may know us, who may understand us, but we should be confident and should have a stronghold that God knows us the best. And God knows us more than we know ourselves. So it is always better to rely on Him as the psalmist relied on God. Let us remember ourselves that no matter who may fail us, but always God is with us. Even before we say, He understands us. So it is better to rely on Him. And overall, ultimately, what should be our goal? Our goal should be praising Him and thanking Him for all that He has done and for all that He understands us. Amen.
Let us sing song number 172, Anbu Kooruven.
அன்பு கூறுவேன் இன்னும் அன்பு கூறுவேன் இன்னும்
Dinakaran for the closing prayer and benediction.
Our most precious Heavenly Father, we praise and thank Thee for this wonderful hour of the moment. Thank You, Lord, for this great day what You granted my life to come before Thy presence to worship You. Thank You, Lord, for the added blessings on this service. Thank You, Lord, Whatever manifestation from the beginning to the end of the service, O Lord, let the blessings of this day be set upon each and every one of those who have taken part in the service, O Father. Thank you, Lord, for the word of God which is given through your servant, Reverend Rachel Susan. As you meditate the word, O Father, we understand. Lord, help us not to put our trust in anyone. Many may fail us, but we know that you are the Lord God who is living, is with us, and he will never fail us, O Father. Help us to abide in you and receive thy blessings and have the better and beautiful spiritual life in Christ till the still our last prayer. Be with us, guide us, and lead us. In Jesus Christ's wonderful name we do pray. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being. Praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
Amen.